Hey everybody, welcome to Brick Vault. Today we're taking a closer look at the Batman Batmobile. Really, that's the name of the TV show from 2004. It's called The Batman, and this is what the Batmobile from that show looked like. It uniquely is one of the most colorful versions of the vehicle, especially if you don't count anything before 1973. And it's also one of the wider Batmobiles with dimensions similar to that of like maybe a Lotus sports car. If you are familiar with our mock videos, you may already know who is behind this custom design. This build comes from the creator Lucas, who to date has more unique custom Lego Batmobile builds under his belt than anyone else. Maybe, I don't know, I just said that, but it's probably true. And you know what else is probably true, or definitely true? The instructions for this build and the rest of the Batmobiles can be found at our web store, www.brickvault.toys. Included with each purchase is a PDF step-by-step set of instructions and a parts list for ordering the pieces online quickly. Buying instructions is a great way to help support us here at the channel, as well as the passionate designers behind these wonderful mocks. Now, before I go any further, for those of you in the comment section below that know all about this TV show, the Batmobile was destroyed at one point and rebuilt throughout the several seasons. This is not that new version of the Batmobile, but the one we see throughout the majority of the show, and it's what most people are familiar with when they think of this series. Right, okay, now that we got that out of the way, let's check out some of the closer details. In the front, you can find a wide bumper with some hints of blue on the sides and a clever hidden couple of hinges on either side to get those slopes offset just by a few extra degrees. I think this Batmobile looks really strong from its profile. Here you can see all the color changes a bit closer together. The mechanical aspects of the vehicle are so tightly packed in there that they're almost pushing out the sides of the doors. Or at least that's where the doors would be. He's always jumping in through the top. It's a simple Technic connector that you see making that cylindrical build, and I think it looks really great. In the back, you can see the ever-present Batmobile fins, this time in blue. Towards the top, there's a combination of curved and rigid slope bricks to complete the detailing. And in the very back, right at the bottom, you can see those grille pieces kind of in a box. That's where the jet thrusters are. Most Batmobiles have some kind of jet propulsion, and this one is no different. Though this time, instead of having a cylindrical thruster sticking out the back like many of the previous iterations, it is hidden behind some extra exhaust slits where it leaves a blue glow behind it instead of your standard flame. There's one big windscreen for this Batmobile, and it leaves plenty of space to fit your Batman minifig. In terms of handling and durability, this model has zero things holding it back. As always, I like to show you how strong a mock is at the end of the review, and this build is as strong or stronger than that of something you might get from a regular Lego playset. Simply nothing is weak or flimsy. Any of the small extremities of this build, of which there are very few, stay on just as strong as the bigger, bulkier parts. So at the end of the day, I would say this mock does the Batman Batmobile justice. It's low, sleek, and hits all the right proportions. It matches a familiar style that fits in with the rest of Lucas's Batmobile creations and has earned its place there rightly with quality building and subtle finesse. Once again, if you would like a mock like this for yourself, the instructions can be found at our web store, www.brickvault.toys, linked in the description below. It comes with a digital parts list too, where you can order the pieces quickly online. All right, if you've stuck around to the end, thanks so much for watching. Remember, if you enjoy our content, feel free to like or subscribe, and we'll see you next time at Brick Vault.